Dit is Papa Alfa 0 Echo Tango Echo voor de Daily Minutes nummer 1144 met een uitzending voor vandaag 26 november 2017. Dus het bulletin van zondag. This bulletin will be almost completely in English. Deze uitzending is bijna geheel in het Engels en is opnieuw wat langer dan gebruikelijk. Er was heel veel interessant nieuws en de column van Onno was vandaag een stuk langer. Later in de week zullen er vrij zeker ook wat vrij korte uitzendingen zijn. Denk trouwens als je wilt nog even aan het chatkanaal van de Daily Minutes. Ik had het daar gisteren al over. Op www.pa0ete.nl is te vinden hoe je daar kunt meedoen. Uitdrukkelijk ook bedoeld voor mensen die via de ether nog niet mee mogen doen.
From Australia, this is VK1WIA and the weekly WIA amateur radio news service.
SBAS trial launched for Australasian region. A national trial of world-first satellite positioning technology has been launched by the Australian government. The satellite positioning technology is known as SBAS, or Satellite-Based Augmentation System, SBAS. The improved positioning accuracy and integrity of the satellite technology will potentially benefit a wide range of industries, including agriculture, mining, transport, construction, and utilities. The first contracts with industry have been signed as part of a two-year trial examining the economic and social benefits of an SBAS for the Australasian region. Minister for Resources and Northern Australia, Matt Canavan, said, "We know that working closely with industries like agriculture is the key to understanding what Australia can gain from investing in technologies that may improve positioning accuracy from the current 5 to 10 metres down to less than 10 centimetres. Central Queensland University, CQ University of Australia, up in Rocky Area, one of the first industry participants to sign up on the trial, is leading a project to test how improved satellite positioning technology can be used by cattle and sheep farmers to lower costs and improve production. Member for Capricornia, Michelle Landry, said CQ University's project would receive up to $180,000 in funding from the Australian and New Zealand governments, with the project partners contributing an additional $105,000.
Mysterious signals did not come from missing submarine. Satellite signals heard over the weekend did not come from the missing Argentine Navy submarine San Juan that went missing November 15, dashing hopes that the vessel could be located. The submarine had reported a malfunction, had surfaced, and was headed back to its base when the Navy lost contact with it. The sub carries a crew of 44. A naval commander told media that the submarine had surfaced and reported an electrical problem before it disappeared some 270 miles off the South American coast. Over the weekend, Argentina's Defense Ministry had reported receiving 7 failed satellite calls that officials thought might be coming from this missing submarine. No contact was made and no transmissions occurred. Over last weekend, International Amateur Radio Union Region 2 news editor Joaquin Solana, callsign X-ray Echo 1 Romeo, issued a list of marine frequencies suggesting that radio amateurs and shortwave listeners listen for any signals that could be related to the missing San Juan. Naturally, we have that list in our text edition of WIA News. Amateur services feature in Free International Telecommunications Union magazine. The new edition of the ITU News magazine features an article by International Amateur Radio Union President Tim Ellum, callsign Victor Echo 6 Sierra Hotel, about the International Amateur Radio Union, the International Radio Consultative Committee, CCIR, and ITUR. The IARU has been and continues to be a regular contributor to the CCIR and the ITU Radio Communications Sector Study Groups and Working Parties on behalf of more than 3 million licensees of the amateur and amateur satellite services throughout the world. They share what they learn with one another and with a wider telecommunications community, in part through ITUR recommendations and reports. ITUR Study Group 5 and Working Party 5 Alpha a home to both the amateur and the amateur satellite services. Radio Caroline heard testing on 648 kHz as it prepares its legal return to the airwaves. Medium wave broadcast listeners recently reported a signal with continuous music and announcements on 648 kHz, the frequency of the former pirate broadcaster and soon to be reconstituted Radio Caroline. From the United Kingdom, the Netherlands, Belgium, France and Austria, they reported hearing the signal, according to Mike Terry of the Shortwave Listening Post. Terry said he believed the testing was done at a lower power level than the permitted 1 kilowatt. The latter-day incarnation of the famous shipboard pirate radio station that beamed rock music to the United Kingdom in the 1960s and the 1970s has gone legal and obtained a license to operate permanently on 648 kHz or 1 kilowatt estimated radiated power. It has taken Radio Caroline 53 years to get an AM license, and it was perceived as a threat to the BBC for many years, Radio Caroline said on its website. Printed circuit board prices to rise on copper foil shortage, says broker. A shortage of copper and copper foil for use by the printed circuit board industry is likely to send prices higher, according to Raymond Goh, chief operating officer of an Oslo, Norway printed circuit board broker. Raymond said that the global output of copper is not increasing, while demand for copper in lithium batteries for automotive applications is, and that as a result, a current shortage of copper foil will persist. On top of this, China is planning to ban the importation of electronic waste, a significant source of recycled copper, Raymond said. Although others will undoubtedly continue to recycle electronic waste, China's exit would represent a disruption to the process, creating a temporary decrease in copper supply. Frequency or wavelength? What is the correct term to use in modern times? Is it frequency or wavelength? In the 1920s, when amplitude-modulated broadcasting started, all radio dials were only calibrated in wavelengths, and radio amateurs operated only on wavelengths measured in meters. In an article prepared by the South African Radio League, they remind us that this continued until 1927, when the International Telecommunications Union held the first International Radio Telegraph Convention of Washington. This is where they allocated the frequency bands with wavelengths for the five official radio services: broadcasting, maritime mobile, fixed, mobile, and amateur. Somewhere along the line, the International Telecommunications Union and the International Amateur Radio Union dropped wavelengths, and all their band plans are only given in a frequency of megahertz. If we compare the frequency bands with the wavelength bands, we find quite a number of errors. For example, the 7 MHz band is actually in the 41 meter band, while the 21 MHz band is in the 14 meter band next to the 13 meter shortwave broadcasting band. Today, all dials on receivers or transceivers are calibrated in frequencies only.
I'm Ono of the Foundations of Amateur Radio podcast in Australia, and you're listening to the Daily Minutes by Papa Alpha Zero Echo Tango Echo. Foundations of Amateur Radio. The frequency you listen and transmit on in a modern radio is derived from a crystal master oscillator. In my case, 22.625 MHz. That master frequency is multiplied and divided to determine the final frequency. To get to 2 meters, you need to multiply by 6. To get to 70 centimeters, multiply by 20. Similarly, to get to 40 meters, divide by 3. Any slight variation of the crystal frequency has an impact. 100 Hz variation in the master oscillator causes the radio to be off by 600 Hz in 2 meters, or 2000 Hz in 70 centimeters. The higher you go, the bigger the error. This leaves us with two problems. If the crystal changes frequency over time, your radio wanders with that change, which is especially noticeable on the higher frequencies. I've previously discussed how you can deal with the variation by correcting for temperature. The other problem is the actual absolute frequency. If the radio is set up for a crystal with one frequency and you replace the crystal with a different one, how do you know what frequency you're actually on? Your dial says one thing, but is that the actual frequency? How do you measure any difference? Is a new radio the same as an old radio? Does the frequency change over time? Measurement is the act of comparing two things. Think of a ruler, wooden stick with markings on it. If the lines on the stick are not drawn in the right place, anything you measure with that stick will not match other sticks. That won't matter if you only ever use your stick to build everything, but typically you use parts supplied by someone else with their own measuring stick. In your radio, the same is true. What the actual frequency is doesn't matter until you need to compare it to the frequency of someone else, like, say, another radio station. The first thing we need is something to compare with, a reference frequency. As it happens, there are several of those around. As an example, you'll find reference broadcasts on 5 MHz, on 10 MHz, 15 MHz and 20 MHz. There are countless other frequencies where you'll find radio time signal stations. These stations broadcast on a steady frequency with a defined signal that you can use to do measurements against. Even your local broadcast stations have a carrier that you can get started with. A typical radio time signal will be an AM station with all manner of information encoded on the transmission. You can tune your radio to the station and hear a talking clock, second marks, etc. Unless your radio is seriously out of whack, you're unlikely to be able to notice any frequency errors. If you tune to the same station with sideband, you'll hear some artifacts, but essentially you'll hear nothing. However, if you tune slightly off frequency, you'll hear a tone. This tone is the central carrier frequency, and it's very accurate. At this point, you can do many things. I'll cover one of them. I'll explain this with 10 MHz. If you set your radio to upper sideband and tune to 9.999 MHz on your radio, you should hear a 1 kHz tone. Similarly, if you set your radio to lower sideband and tune to 10.001 MHz, you'll also hear a 1 kHz tone. In essence, you're listening to the carrier as a 1 kHz audio tone. You can swap between the two frequencies by setting one on VFOA and the other on VFOB and switching between them with the AB switch on your radio. If the tone changes, your radio is off frequency. How much off frequency is determined by the difference between the two tones. By lowering both frequencies by the same amount, or raising both by the same amount, one of the tones will go up while the other one goes down, and vice versa. Once you've got both the tones the same, write down both frequencies, split the difference, and you'll know what frequency your radio thinks 10 MHz is on. You'll need a radio with both upper and lower sideband and the ability to switch between two frequencies. And before you get started, you need to make sure that your radio doesn't have any frequency changing stuff turned on. RIT, clarifier, offset, whatever it's called on your radio. All of them need to be off. There are countless other ways of doing this. A procedure called zero beating with a signal strength meter. Using a tone and listening for a wobble in the sound. Using an external second receiver and zero beating against that. Using a computer to generate tones. Using the FMT software included with the Whisper software. And likely many more. The point of all these processes is to detect a difference where there shouldn't be one. One final comment. The most accurate process at this time without specialist measuring equipment is by using your Whisper-enabled computer and the FMT software that's included. I'll look at that next time, if I can understand what Joe Kilo 1 Juliet Tango wrote on the subject. Happy measuring. I'm Onno, a Victor Kilo 6, Foxtrot Lima Alpha Bravo. Ik ben Onno van de podcast Foundations of Amateur Radio in Australië. En je luistert nu naar de Daily Minutes van Papa Alpha Zero Echo Tango Echo.
Daily Minutes zijn dagelijks vanaf ongeveer 1900 uur te beluisteren via PI2 NOS. De uitzending wordt een dag later om 10:30 ochtends herhaald. Alle mail is welkom op het adres x@xdv.me. Dat is ook te vinden rechts bovenaan de webpagina van de uitzendingen www.pa0ete.nl. Dit is Papa Alpha 0 Echo Tango Echo. De Daily Minutes toont iedere dag weer aan de hand van schokkende voorbeelden hoe een hobby mensenlevens kan veranderen. De Daily Minutes komt tot stand mede dankzij de stichting Scope Hobbyfonds.
En microfoon naar retour.